So guys, they're foodier, so you want full body tracking in VR, but you don't want to spend over $300 on 3 Vive trackers, or maybe you don't have the Vive and you have Oculus and Windows Mixed Reality and you want just to have full body tracking there too. That's the way to do it. We're going to explain in this video how to prepare the Kinect, taking the dust off, to have full body tracking in every VR headset. But first, thank you so much for watching. If you're new from the channel, feel free to check out all the other videos in the channel. And if you like what you see and want to keep being updated about VR tech in general from PAX and D32, just click or tap the subscribe button so you don't miss anything. That'd be super appreciated, will help a lot the channel, and basically that's it. Anyway, let's go back in topic and see in the first video how to prepare the Kinect for the PC. In the second video, we're gonna do how to let it work with the computer, and the third video we're gonna see if the experience worth it, the time and the effort or not. Let's try. And here we are to the table. Let's see what we need to prepare the Kinect to connect with the computer. So, electrical tape, power adapter, USB 3.0 type A to type B, soldering iron, iron, scissors, pliers, maybe, screwdriver, screwdriver torx kit, hammer, drill, a stick of RAM DDR2, glass of water, a banana, a plant, two ants, and some luck. Hold on, wait a minute, let's go back. Torx kit, and of course, our Kinect. Okay, first of all, we have to start taking out the cable from the Kinect. I already did it to show you. This part here has these two flaps, so it's gonna be a little hard to take it out, but don't worry, you can do it. Just wiggle it a little when you try. Okay, after that is out, what we have to do is to start to open the Kinect, and we have to turn it over, and here there's gonna be two stickers, so we have to take those two stickers out. So let's take our screwdriver and let's start to take out the sticker from here. That could be take a little time if you are like me, not patient at all with the stickers. Let me see, and here we are, gentle. As you can see, it's coming out and it's showing the screws that are under it. Okay, here we are. One is gone. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. And they're gonna be Torx. Don't know if you're able to see them. And here the second. Let's see if I'm gonna destroy it or not. And be aware anyway, oh, look at this old Microsoft. Look at that, Microsoft. Be aware that anyway, of course, your warranty is gonna get expired with this. And of course, I had the wrong Torx kit, so I had to run to the hardware store and get a new Torx kit because we're gonna need the T9. So be aware of it, like I wasn't. And let's take the T9, that should be somewhere here. Jeez, it's so stiff. And let's unscrew everything now. Okay, here we are. So we took 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 out, where the two on the bottom are a little longer. And I did a little stupid thing over here to remember where they are at. Of course, when I move it, it's gonna all messed up, but so we can remember where are places. And now we have to open the Kinect. So let's see how to do. This part is just coming out super easy. And that's what inside the Kinect, nice. And then I think we have to take off here, the sides we can take off. And 1 and 2. And there are other two screws over here. Like this part, so it's gonna be one screw here and one screw here. Let's take it off again with our Torx. And one out. And the second two. So here we are. Let's try to take it out now. Seems like it's coming out all in one piece, and there are some clip here. One. Why I didn't watch a tutorial? Okay. So yeah, it came out like just on this side and snap these little flaps over here. So pretty easy. And here is the internal of our Kinect. It's pretty nice. Look at that. Look at that. And yeah, now the other step will be to solder to these little pins over here the cables. So let's see to do it together. Okay, now let's take our power adapter, and what we have to do is to cut here because we don't need that anymore, because that's where we're gonna connect the power part. So let's cut it and let's open it in a way that we can. Let's see if I'm able to let you see, guys. Okay, and let's open in a way that we can take out the cable. Okay, probably you're gonna be better than me at these things. I'm not good at all. It's actually the first time. So, if you are to the first time too, don't worry, because if I can do it, you can do it too. So here are the two cables, why I cut it so little. Stupid me. Okay, here we are with the two, and now the other part is these little guys over here. So let's do little cuts. And let's take out one. Okay, and the second one here too. So we have finally our two cables, the plus and the ground. So let's twist it a little. And then what you have to do is to arrive to this pin here, passing through this part here, so you're not gonna pull your cables in a wrong way and you're not gonna break them. That's pretty important, because if you pull it, then you're gonna break it, and that is gonna be a big problem. And here we are. So to put it there, just twist it a little, put it together, the cables, and you do like this. Super, super easy. And then the hard part will be, for me at least, and I never did in my life, I just saw my dad doing it, would be to put those in the pins over there. And we're gonna have to solder, of course. Okay, so we have to take the soldering thing ready to make it warm. The iron now, and here where we have to connect the cables. So the number 10 and the ground that is gonna be on this side here, close to the 11. So not much space. I'm pretty newbie doing this kind of things. So for sure I'm gonna destroy the Kinect, but let's try, right? Okay, so cables are ready. Iron is ready. Cables are not ready really. So let's put them all inside again. Oh my God, I'm scared. Okay, so the white usually will be the ground. So we put it on the ground. There's no much space there, so really, I'm screwed. But let's try. So the white is here, and we can just try to do something. Let me see. Why did you guys from Microsoft discontinue this thing? Why? Okay, one is done and looks very bad. And let's do the second one now. It's
cut it because we don't need it too long. It's important to don't let it touch the other contacts. Okay, here is very small, so put a little of attention to it.
Okay, so this is for sure the worst job you ever seen in your life. I had to take some time trying to do that, and I think I destroyed the pin number 4. So we're gonna see together at the end if it works or not over here. Anyway, let's put some tape on it so we are not gonna have interference or stuff, and also it's gonna be harder for it to move too much around. Really, Microsoft, why did you freaking discontinue that? And should be fine. And then let's put on the USB cable already. The cable is gonna just stay in place over here and not gonna move. Here we are with it. So like, it's better to run it from the side, and we have it. So the cable is there, it's not gonna come out easily. And we can also, if we want, put these two cables together. So I'm gonna be sure it's not gonna move too much. And now let's assemble again the Kinect. Okay, so let's take all these flaps up a little so they're gonna just get in again. Let's try now. Let's be sure that the camera is gonna be clean. And let's put it back. Okay. And remember to put before the screws over here back, and then we can put the sides again in. So just slide them in the little ray that they have over here and just pop them in. Here you are with one and the other one here. Okay, and then we put the last part or the back over here again. Oh, the other way. And we close it in, and we have to put back our screws. So in our diagram, of course, all is messed up, but let's start again, putting all the little screws in the top holes and the long screw on the bottom. So let's screw all in. I'll be back in a second. And here we are, all the screws are in. So let's go see if it works or it's gonna explode in our hands. Let's go see. Come on, Kinect. Lights on. Lights on. Stay on. Stay on. Come on, Kinect. Come on, Heather. Sorry, the mess. Over here, Kinect is ready to go. Yes. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so unbelievable, it worked. And I'm saying unbelievable because I destroyed the pin and like just came out, and when I was closing, like there were kind of like weird sounds, so I was sure 100% that wouldn't be a total fail, but actually it worked with the Xbox. I didn't want to connect it to the PC because actually the Xbox is the cheapest thing compared to the PC. And if I did it, guys, you can do it for sure. So if you have a Kinect, like it was the first time for me soldering, the first time for me, I don't know, like with all those cables and like trying to work on a pin, and it worked. So really, you can do it. But we're gonna see in the next video about the PC with the tracking, if it works and everything. So I see you guys in the next video. And if you like the video, like. If you didn't like the video, dislike. Let me know in the comment below what you think about it. And subscribe to the channel for more about VR. And of course, the next two videos. Ciao!